Today we're going to do the waistband casing to hold up our boxer shorts. So we're going to take our raw edge here at the top of our shorts, and we're going to lay the fashion fabric onto the ironing board, and we're going to turn this down. And we want to turn this down about 1 centimeter. Now, it's not really critical that we measure the 1 centimeter, but we want to get a good eyesight on this so we can see how much we actually want to turn under. We're just going to take our iron, and so we've got the iron on steam and on heat, and we're going to press this under all the way around, because when we work, we always want to make sure that we finish our seams, and by turning it under, we're going to have the waistband have a finished edge on it. All right, once the whole waistband has been turned under like this, we're going to now turn it to the inside again, and this makes the casing. And the casing for the waistband will be 1 centimeter larger than our elastic. So our elastic in this case is 2.5 centimeters. So we're going to make our casing, this distance, 3.5 centimeters. So if your elastic was 2 centimeters, your casing would be 3 centimeters. In our case, ours is going to be 3.5 centimeters. As you can see by the centimeter sign, that's 3.5. And we're going to press this all the way around. Make sure that you check it. And if you can, press it with the iron, press it with the iron. If you can't, you can always do what we call a fingertip press. So once I actually check it on this end, I can just hold it here and it all lines up and makes a nice 3.5 casing. So line this up as well so that this seam lines up with that seam to keep things together. It's a little bit bigger here. And check again that we're at our 3.5 centimeters. There we go. And then we're going to press it. Now, if the iron was busy and I couldn't get to the iron, I was having to wait too much time, I could just do what I call the fingertip press. And that's where I would just take this and I would measure it here at 3.5 centimeters again, like I have here on this. And I would just press it. Just give it a press like that. So if I cannot get to the iron because the iron is being used by other students in the classroom right now, then I can just do what we call a fingertip press. And let's check this one again to make sure we're at 3.5 centimeters. It's too small. I need to bring it over a bit more. So I'm at 3.5 centimeters there. And I'm going to press it and press this together just to hold it all in the same spot. All right. Now what I want to do is I'm going to take this to the table and I'm going to use my pins and pin this down before I start sewing on it. So I'll place this on the table. I like my pins out so I don't get poked. All right, and then I'm going to take this and I'm going to press it down like that. And I'm going to have because I'm right-handed, I'll put the pin at this end. If I was left-handed, I would pin it this way. Okay, but because I'm right-handed, I put the pin over here. All right, so I'm going to just go along here and press this down. Make sure it's anchored with my pins. Trim along here where I want it to be. Now I need to leave an opening. I'm going to do edge stitching like I did on the hem. I'm going to do it here around the waistband. But I need to make sure I leave an opening because my elastic has to go in here. So I usually go to the back here at the seam and I'll put 2 pins as a reminder to myself that things are going to change up here. So I'll put 2 pins together. That's going to be for a stop. And I'll put 2 pins together here for a start. So I know that I need to start here. And then I just need to leave about that much of an opening. So if I look on here, I'm going to say about 4 centimeters to leave my opening about that big. All right, now what I want to do here is I want to do edge stitching, and edge stitching like that I did on the bottom of my hem. All right, let me just move my pins away from here. I've already set my machine up, and I've already made sure that I'm on the correct stitch length and the correct tension. My take-up lever's in the right hand, at the upright position, and my threads are at the back. I'm on A03. I'm going to be sewing quite close to the edge. So I need to be careful to line this up correctly. So I've got my machine all organized. I'm looking here, inside here, and I'm looking at the edge of the fabric. So let's drop our needle down and drop our pressure foot down, and I'm going to remove my pins because those were telling me that's the place to start. When I look in here, I should see right in here just the fold, and that's where I want it to be. So my stitches are close to this edge. I want them to be close to this edge all the way around. I don't want them up here because there might not be enough room for my elastic to run easily through. So I need to stitch by the edge so there's enough room for the elastic to go through the casing. And also, by stitching close to the edge, I'm making sure that the raw edge cannot slip out here, that this raw edge that I've turned up cannot all of a sudden get out at the bottom and then I have a dirty looking raw edge or frayed looking raw edge. All right, so let's get started. We're going to start with a reverse right away and then we're ready to go. All right, and don't sew over your pins. Make sure you remove them as you sew. And make sure your fingers are on this side of this line so that you don't accidentally sew on top of yourself. When you get to your pin, remove it. Put your sewing machine needle down when you're removing the pin so that the fabric doesn't slip at all. And don't go too fast. Stop, take a look, press under. And when you want to take a look, put your pressure foot, make sure your needle down and pressure foot down. Have a look on the back side to make sure our stitching is good. So I'm happy. I wanted to sew in a color that you could easily see. So I'm happy the way it looks for my stitch length and the positioning on here. So I'm only looking at the needle and its place on the fold here. I'm not looking anywhere else on the sewing machine. I'm listening to hear that the sewing machine is humming along the way it should. When I get up here, I know that the machine now has to go through many layers. In fact, 6 layers of fabric. So I'm not pulling here. I'm just holding it at the back. Seems a little bit struggling there. So I lifted it up to help it get over the hump here. There we go. Over a little bit. There we go. And on we go. Make sure your garment is flat, so there's nothing underneath it. This is nice and flat on the machine arm here. So we're almost to the end, making sure if you don't have your needle down, when you go to move your fabric, you will have slipped your garment out from its position on with the needle in the stitch length. So you want to make sure always that you have your needle down so the next stitch is the same length as the one that you just sewn previously. Now again, we're coming up to this big hump that we have to get over here, so let's give it just a tiny little bit of pressure there to get over it. There we go, up and over, and we're coming down here. We're going to stop when we get to that spot, and I'm just going to do a couple of stitches in reverse. There we go, good, and I'll just do one and two. There we go. All right, so now we've done the stitching. Take your take-up lever to the upright position. Bring your garment to the side here, and then we'll just reach across for our sewing shears and cut our threads here at the corner. By cutting out here, I give myself enough length so that I can press these to the back, and when I start up stitching, I won't unthread my machine. Let's push that to the side now. All right, so let's take a good look at your garment here and be sure that you're happy and you haven't got any extra stitches anywhere. So you haven't accidentally caused a pleat or anything in here when you've been stitching. And when you're happy with that, I would take this and just pull on these. And then once you're sure they're secure, you can just cut them off. If you've correctly reversed on them, they are not going to undo. So we'll just trim those ones and this one so we have them out of the way. And now we're going to take our elastic and thread it through here. All right, so this has been sewn correctly. Now we need the elastic to hold them up. So I'm just going to reach over here for the elastic. Now the elastic is already pinned onto a diaper pin. This diaper pin has a top that closes so that while I'm pulling it through the casing, it can't accidentally open up and accidentally hurt us. So here's the opening that I had in my garment, and I'm going to place this inside here. I need to make sure that when I'm pulling this through that I don't let this elastic twist, and I don't want the whole end to go inside. I need to have it at the end here. So when you place it through, you're going to have the top end in your hand here, and you just slide, and your thumb is pushing against the end of this diaper pin here. So you push and you slide the fabric over so that you're kind of grabbing it as you do this. Just sliding, and you get a couple fingers to hang on like a claw, and then pull. And make sure that this is lying flat as you pull it through. So I'm pulling the fabric when I do that, not anything else, and it allows the elastic to go in. Okay, now I don't want to pull this any further, so what I'm going to do is just stick a pin in here to make sure that it doesn't disappear on me, and then I'll have to start this through again. So I'm just pinning it to secure it. Now when I pull it, you'll see that it will gather up this. So I'm pushing this over, I'm pushing the head of the pin through here, and now I just pull the garment, and you can see how it's gathering because it needs to have some resistance to hold our shorts up. Here's the pin coming out. Now I need to make sure when I pull this pin out that I don't allow this elastic to twist on me. So I want to make sure there's no twists in my elastic. It's very uncomfortable to have twisted elastic in your boxer shorts. Now I've got my two ends of the boxer shorts here. I can take the pin out here because I'm secure with it. And I'm going to sew it together. When I sew it together, I want these to be flat on each other so it's comfortable on the center back where this will be placed in your garment. So while I do that, I'm just going to pull this out, and I'm going to take this over to my sewing machine. I'm going to put this onto a one zigzag. So I like to turn all the way to 5 and back to a 1. I want my machine to know it's going to do a little zigzag. So that's the only change I make, and I'm going to make a square here. in here, I'm just going to lower my pressure foot down. I see where the end of my elastic is. That's how far I'm going to sew. So I'm going to put this together. Make sure it doesn't fold on itself like that, or you'll have three layers. You only want to sew the top and the bottom together. That's all you're going to do. So when you get over here to the end, just hand wheel so you're happy. Now do a pivot, needle down, pressure foot up. Make sure you're still only sewing on two. Turn it again. You're still just sewing on two. Hand wheel it down. Pivot again. We're sewing on two pieces of elastic together. And when I come to the beginning, where I started from, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take these two pieces of thread to the side, and I'm going to start down this just a little bit more. I don't want to do a reverse on the elastic. So I've secured it now. My take-up lever is in the upright position. I'm going to pull through here, and I'm going to trim, cut the threads at the corner so I have nice long threads to start my machine up again. And I check this to make sure it all goes in here smoothly, hidden away, and even out my gathers. And what I want to do now is I want to try these on, just make sure they fit. If I'm happy with this, then I'm going to sew the opening shut. So I'm going to believe I've already pre-measured these for myself, so I know that this is the right elastic for me. I want each one of you to try them on to make sure you're happy before you sew them closed. Now we're going to sew the opening closed as the final step. So make sure we turn our machine back to a straight stitch, so A03. We're going to go in here. Now what we want, we don't want to make this difficult for ourselves because it looks a little gathered. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take my elastic, pull a bit of it out here so I make it nice and smooth, and then I'll let it go. So it's got lots of elastic in here, and I can make sure this area is smooth while I'm sewing on it. So just pull it out a bit. Now, there we go, underneath here. And I'm going to put my needle right down where I was before. So I want it to be exactly on the stitches, just in here where I already had it. And back a little bit. See how I'm starting just a little bit back? And now I'm going to go and I'm going to stitch this opening shut. And I want to make sure I can see the edge there as I'm edge stitching along here. Go slowly. Do not sew in your elastic. Your elastic should be over here. We just want to go along here till we match up again where we were before. A couple stitches, do one reverse. There we go. Take up lever in the upright position, bring it out to the corner again. Trim your threads nice and close here. And nice and close here. We don't want to have a hairy garment, so we want to make sure that we've got all our extra threads on one side. There we go. All right, now we've got our garment all ready to be worn. We've got our hems done, and we've got our casing done all the way around. This is a completed waistband casing for your boxer shorts.